our ignorance and with our fear, we forget our natural love. And suffering's not an individual matter. We can't escape our connection to all people, all nations, and the world. When we truly learn to care for others, we're caring for ourselves. So shine the light of wisdom and come together. We must build our hope as a family to help clear up that sky of despair. Practice embracing your hurt to help heal the hurt in man. Promise me this day, promise me now, while the sun is exactly overhead, even as they strike you down with a mountain of hate, even as they crush you like a worm, even as they dismember you, oh please, oh please remember my brother, that man is not our enemy. The only thing worthy of you is compassion, invincible, limitless, and unconditional. Hatred will never let you face the beast in man. One day when you face this beast alone, with your courage intact and your eyes kind, untroubled, from your smile will bloom a flower, and those who love you will be hold you across 10,000 worlds. Alone again, I'll go on with bent head, knowing that love has become eternal. And on the long rough road, the sun and the moon will continue to shine. A gift to ourselves and the world. concern with peace for all humanity.
Can the peace movement talk in loving speech, showing the way for peace? I think that would depend on whether the people in the peace movement can be peace, because without being peace, we cannot do anything for peace. If you are not peaceful, and then you cannot contribute to the peace movement. We need people who understand who are capable of being in touch with people. To reconcile the conflicting parties.
And we should be able to say like this: dear friends, dear people, I know that you suffer a lot. I have not understood enough of your difficulties and suffering. It's not our intention to make you suffer more. It is the opposite. So please tell us about your suffering, your difficulties. I'm eager to learn to understand. It has to start like that, loving speech. And if we are honest, if we are true, they will open their heart and tell us. And then we practice compassionate, deep listening. And during the process of deep listening, we can learn so much about our own perception and their perception. And that is the best way, the only way to
attack me, what would it look like to look for my compassion even when I'm so afraid? What, how brave would it be to look deeply to understand those who just attack me? What would it look like? Look for my compassion, even when I'm so afraid, searching for the enemy of mine. To understand those who just attack me, I know we're not victims of others, but of our ignorance and of theirs. I'm so afraid. Two more times.